Hello, welcome to another Parkinson's Walks Friday vlog. As you can see, it's actually stopped raining for a few minutes. It was raining earlier on, it's going to be raining in a minute, no doubt. But at the moment, it stopped raining and now we've got high winds. The old conifer's going well. The photina keeps blowing itself inside out. And Pauline's special tulips don't look quite so special. But look at this cherry blossom tree. Isn't that beautiful? Well, there you are. The weather is one of these, I suppose. We just have to put up with it. Right, now, let's see what our friends from around the world have been up to this last week. See what's been going on, and we're doing matters arising from the last vlog film, which was Fetters Hill in the Forest of Dean, and then last week's Gotherington. So let's start off with Fetters, but before we do that, let's hear from James in Canada. James, our school teacher in Canada. You ready for this? James says, I was out late last night doing report cards that are due next week. James is a teacher, so he has to fill out all the report cards, for goodness knows what. One of his favourite tasks, I'm sure, judging by this. Doing report cards means thinking about doing report cards. So my mind turned to one of my clocks that wasn't doing quite the clock thing that it should be. And I worked on that for a while. He's a great tinkerer, is James, loves his clocks. Then OVM, that's the official virtual mascot, Sumac. Morning, Sumac. Needed to be taken out for her last outing of the day before bed. After that, I got a notification that your latest video was out, so we watched that and thoroughly enjoyed it. I'm still thinking about doing report cards. No good thinking about it, James. They won't do themselves, will they? Good old James. Ah, oh, dear. Marilyn. Says, good morning. When I logged on at 7 a.m. this morning, 7 a.m. this morning, 61 people had already watched your video. That's a pretty fair achievement, reckons Marilyn. Lovely scenery as always, this is Fetters Hill. And lovely to see the bluebells coming through. It's so cold in Cheshire at the moment, they might not bother. Oh dear. Jim, from New Zealand. He reckons the forest scenery was really beautiful, except for the pine plantation at the end. Jim's not a fan. We have one at the end of our road, and it's dark, dank, and a miserable place. Give me a good English beach forest any time. Oh, yeah. You are rather pretty, James. Jim? Right, abandoned railways. Ron. Ron's just down. I don't know if you've caught up with his latest film. On spec, having perused the map and Google Earth, he went out looking for a bridge and he found it, and you've never seen such a magnificent bridge. Apparently it was en route to a manor house, which will explain it, but it's a beautiful bridge. Go and take a look. Very good. Anyway, Ron says, that cutting, wow, what a magnificent feat, a pure graft by the navvies. Yeah, solid rock, and they chiseled and chipped their way through that. Brilliant work. Trev. Ah, Trev. He says, my birthday today. Ah, oh, belated happy birthday to you then, Trev. That would have been last Friday then. Ah, right. And my brother is up to stay for a couple of weeks. Oh, nice. So as we will be spending a lot of time out and about, I will not have time to post any detailed history on the subject of this and next week's video. But I will be back. You have been warned. Yeah, you're going to enjoy yourself, Trev. I know you enjoy your walking. Hopefully your brother does too. What a lovely way to spend some time, isn't it? With your brother. Wonderful. The hairy golfer, our Simon, chips in next. Sadly, at the moment, no golf. Everywhere is still closed. That's due to the water, of course, or the rain that we've been having. Everywhere is closed still and has been for months. I saw some video yesterday of Brickhampton Golf Club. That's between Gloucester and Cheltenham. and it would be right to say that the golf course is in the stream rather than the stream in the golf course. Blimey, it must be 70 yards wide. Wow. But the problem with that is, even once the water's gone, you then have to repair the damage, don't you? That's going to be a long, drawn-out job, I should think. Crikey. Lionel and Mary Travels. Lionel's just put out a video on a traction engine museum. Very interesting. Lionel gives you lots of information on that as well. Yeah, I found that one fascinating, Lionel. And he says, lots of industry in that forest. I wonder how many tons of stone they got out of those quarries. Yeah, I wonder. Can you imagine that was one solid ridge where we walked and they'd been in there and taken all that stone out. Crikey, it must be thousands and thousands of tons. Good Lord. David from Spain. Ah, David from Spain. Yet another great matters arising. It's always good to listen to the comments from around the world. Yep, certainly is. Well done, guys. Back home now, because David and his good lady wife have taken advantage of the Easter holidays, or took advantage of the Easter holidays, and went out visiting round and about. He said, we're back home now, but we're in the midst of a series of storms, bringing wind, rain, sleet and snow. Well, we haven't had the sleet and snow yet. Many of the Easter processions were cancelled. Excuse me. Yeah, I suspect they might have been. Blimey. Peter Smith. Ah, ooh, now. Excuse me. This is interesting. I was given a kitten. No, not that bit. Now sadly gone to the great cattery in the sky. By somebody who lived at Fetter Hill. The donor told me it was once a thriving industry there, making fetters, manacles, leg irons and other restraints, hence the name. I hesitate to think what uses they were put to, but surely not the slave trade, I hope. Ooh, that doesn't bear thinking about, does it? Crikey. Well done, David. Right, the film last week, Gotherington Station. On the Gloucester and Warwickshire Heritage Railway. Malcolm liked it. Malcolm Richardson, who says, delightful portrait of what must be one of the most beautifully preserved halts on any railway, with a cornucopia of memorabilia to engage your attention while you wait for the arrival of one of GWR's immaculately turned out engines. The pine trees and the distant hills add to the atmosphere of the place. Well, in one paragraph you've summed the whole thing up there. Well done, Markham. Right. Abandoned railways again then. He said, I've been through Gotherington a couple of times on the train. You can't appreciate what's been achieved on the site when you're in a moving carriage. No, you've got to get out and have a hunt around to do that, Ron. Definitely. Barry Walker. Barry, I'm not sure if Barry was upset with this or not. He says, the owners have done a fabulous job of restoring the station, etc. I, for one, would not complain about the chimneys, slabs or anything whatsoever. I don't know if you thought I was complaining about it or criticising it, Barry. But no, I was just observation. I think they did very well. Now then, Christina. Just look at the beautifully kept house and gardens. They were wonderful, weren't they? I wonder if Adlestrop was like this. The scene reminds me of the poem. I think Christina's got a thing about Adlestrop. I've actually done the film, which included the poem. It's on the channel, and I've given her a link to get there. Keep it quiet, 5 or 5 minutes, hopefully. Ah, now, Stephen here, Chappell, Stephen Chappell. The line of pine trees indicate the original length of the platforms. I didn't know that. That's how it works, is it? So, if you want to know the original length, go have a hunt around and look at all the pine trees. I see. Lionel again. Such nostalgia, he says. Do the trains always stop there? Or did they think you were waiting to board? Well, I'm conscious of the fact in these halts that sometimes that is the case. If there's somebody there, they'll stop to pick them up. But no, I always keep a low profile, so hopefully that didn't happen. And people did actually get off the train, so... I think I justified myself there. Hopefully, moving swiftly on. Ah, Simon again then, our hairy golfer, says, I'm paying my own visit to a preserve line, the Butterfield line. Everybody know where that is? It's a new one on me. It probably shouldn't be, but it is. He says the Butterfield line is a little farther north. You can ride all day for a tenner, blimey, that's cheap, and you can be a driver for a fiver as well. Wow. That sounds very economic, doesn't it? I should look more into that. Now, Simon's doing one of these graduated retirement jobs, and he's just finished his first year already, which I thought went pretty quick. And Simon says, I've got 1 year, 360 days to go. Not that I'm counting. No, of course not. Michael Miller, he thought it was pretty good. He said, to have a vintage station to yourself with the occasional vintage train passing through with wonderful scenery, beautiful flower arrangements on the station, what more could you ask for? What more indeed? Yeah, I did enjoy my day out there, I have to say. Michael from Poland. Nostalgia served up from an authentic country station. Yeah. A beautiful sight, and congratulations to the family that own the station buildings. They've done an excellent job in preserving yesteryear. Yeah, a lot of hard work and thought gone into that, hasn't it? And just hunting around the country for relics and bits and pieces. Yeah, they've done a good job. West Country Wanderings. Now, Paul, of course, has done a film at Gotherington a little while back. And he said it's a superb location for filming steam trains. Usually quiet there too. Yeah, now, Paul's dad's not very well at the moment, so Paul's staying close to home. And to try and make sure that he's available. We hope poor dad gets better soon. David from Spain. Excuse me. He spotted the sign for Malawati Tea. Malawati Tea. Oh. And I had a quick look on Wikipedia. He said it's a fascinating read. It was registered as a trademark for retail sales in January 1887. Wow. David gives you a little bit more history there if you want to go and look at his comment, and you might also like to tune into Wikipedia. Now, David's a bit of an adventurer on the side down there in Spain. He says, this week I ventured up one of the valleys to see the hydroelectric power station. I've been following the canal that provides water from the top of the valley, some 1,200, now you've put feet there, but I reckon that could probably meters higher. The river was in full flow, I bet it was, and had a bluey-white colour to it, which I've only seen from the glacial water in Norway. I got there in the end, look, David, just hanging in there. Then he goes on to say, in the end, I climbed the zigzag path up to the valley side to get some photos of the high mountains, and in the end got most of the way there. I kept saying to myself, I'm only going to the next bend in the path, but I just kept going. I'm glad I did in the end. We all know that feeling, don't we? I just go see what's around that corner. You get there, and what do you see? Well, another corner. So you come this far. I know the feeling, David. And you end up miles from home if you're not careful. Right. We're nearly there, folks. Donny. Ah, yes. It's a lovely film in a smashing part of the world. My son and I, says Donny, had a great day following the railway line along and ended up on this chap's driveway taking photos of his artifacts. And very amenable he was too. Yeah, I've heard that. A very nice fellow by all accounts. Good. It was like stepping back in time, says Donny. We were ready for our cup of tea and slice of cake by the time we got to Winchcombe. I can imagine you would. Crikey. Blimey. Charles from the US of A. He says that was certainly a treat, and many kudos to the family that owns that station. They put a tremendous amount of effort into upkeep, yeah, and all the flowers were a very nice touch. It was definitely a serenely beautiful visage, and yeah, wouldn't it just, Charles? Beautiful. Right, now, Roger Cook, I had a comment from Roger this week, who says, I'm currently in a very warm Thailand, and watching your videos keeps me in touch with beautiful England. Now, apparently Roger goes to Thailand in the winter, comes back and spends the summer on a narrow boat in this country. What a wonderful life. Yeah, well done you, Roger. Beautiful. And he goes on to say, and now I feel almost as if you've become friends so many miles away. Yeah, well, good. Stay with us on the channel then, Roger. You're one of our friends as well. Join in the party, as they say. Right, now film archive this week is Withington on the Midland and South Western Junction Railway. This is one of the very first films that I did on an abandoned railway. So I put the effort in. It's all been downhill ever since. Not really. Yeah, so anyway, we're going to have a look at Withington and surroundings and pick up a little bit of the railway around there. And then next week, we've recently come back from a week in Cornwall. Now, whenever we go to Cornwall these days, I always think, should I take the camera? I mean, I've been going there for 30 years. There can't be anything left to film. But, well, give it a shot. And this is the result. I hope you'll enjoy that. So we'll wander off down to Cornwall next Friday. Don't be late. Hi, welcome to the new studio. I recently bought a book on abandoned railways in the Cotswolds, and in particular the Midland and South Western Junction Railway. As the name implies, it was built to join the industrial Midlands with the ports in the south of England so they could get their products exported. The bit that the book concentrates on is around Cheltenham to Swindon, and the bit we're going to look at today is the bit around the sleepy little village of Withington. To build a railway in the Cotswolds is not a mean feat. There's not much level land up there, especially between Cheltenham and Swindon, going the route that they went. So they were doing lots of digging, excavating, lots of building up embankments. Huge, huge engineering feat. And yet today, unless you know where to look, you can't find anything. So with that in mind, I thought we'd set out, go and have a look, see what we can find. This old railway map gives you the route. There's a major trunk railway there, which goes off to Oxford. And here's our little branch down here, all the way down to Swindon. And this is a bit we're interested in, Withington. Entrance to Withington Station. On the left, what you see is the track that went to the actual railway station. These days we're sent up there, which will take us over a bridge. From the parapet, that's the line going on into Withington, in a deep cutting. And then on the opposite side is the station, apparently. And coming back just a little bit to try and peer around the side of the parapet, down there, ladies and gentlemen, is Withington Station. Opened in 1891, closed in 1961. And can you just make out the line of a platform edge just of here? Difficult, isn't it? There's supposed to be a platform still there somewhere. And if we go back just a little bit, this is 1956, and that's Withington Station, from where we are now. 7 years later, 1963, and this is the railway being dismantled. They're not putting them down, they're pulling them up. And this must be the far end of the platform, which is the one away from the bridge, of course. And the caption here tells me, although I've got no way of verifying it, that this is the view in the cab of the locomotive charged with removing all the sleepers.
And the station now has other uses. Looks very much like a woodyard to me. And the bridge, as you can see, is itself getting taken over by nature. Let's have a little look, see if we can peer around the side. And there, as you can see, is the bridge we've just been on. Mind you, it looks to have seen better days. And then here, if we look to the right, you can actually just about see the start of the station platform. Just in there, do you see it? The sloping bit, which is this bit just up here. Let's take a closer look. They've actually got their piles of wood on the platform, look. I don't know if this is going to work, because it's a bit dark and dank down in there. Yeah, look, if you look very carefully, you can see the brick corbelling, which is the bit that took the platform out over the wall that was on the side of the rail, which formed the platform. It's complicated. And here, look, a whole length of platform. Been straddled by the bars. Once a thriving station. Obviously not thriving enough, but there you go. And that then, folks, is Withington Station. Telegraph poles stay. And just there, as that indicates, is the other end of the platform, so we've come the full length. Of course, that's probably the up line on that side, and this is the down side on this line. And we haven't shown the downside platform, because we don't want to get thrown out. But it's just up here, look. Just this side of the line of trees. This tells a story, doesn't it? You have an old original part sleeper fence post there, still standing. Its partner, a modern expensive concrete structure, has suffered from frost damage. So you don't build them like they used to. And back to the bridge, and you've got typical Midland Railway architecture here, look. Large coping stone on top of the pillar, and then blue engineering brick all the way along the top of the bridge. And it's amazing what you can find if you look carefully. There was once a gate here, many moons ago, and the latch is still there. Then just peering over the other side of the bridge, shows it to be in rather poor condition, with quite a large pile of waste down here. From there, which is part of the arch. And the cutting extends off down there. Wheelbarrow, shovel, man with big muscles. Can we give you a sense of the depth? I doubt it, to be honest. There at the top is the field, pan on down, and there's the base. Typical of a rail scene in the Cotswolds. This one's near Sapperton, and it shows the usual mixture, cuttings, embankments, and a very steep gradient. And then finally, thank you. And before we cross this next tower then, if we take a look, that's the direction the railway has come from, the cutting that we were in. If I pan slowly round to the left, it now turns into an embankment. I have to say, a rather fine bridge. Well, good news, the bridge has had some remedial work done on it, probably because it forms part of a public footpath. Nice bit of pointing there. Bad news is, to get to it, are we going to go through that? I favour the sneak around the outside method. And here we see on the abutments, rather fine stone wall on that side, a nice coping stone there, and a mixture of stone and brick leading to the bridge. And viewed from the top, still got the original fencing on this side, whilst that direction is the way we've just come from. And that looks to be a fine old mill with the church in the background. Well, as you might better hear, the wind is getting up. I have to say, it's a bit blessed cold. Primary school. So, a walk through town is called for. Fine old corner post here protecting the house. With rope marks on. Strange. The mill inn. The mill stream, and the mill stream from the other direction with a nosy pheasant. Corner of the car park, and you can see the embankment carries on along. Then here in the corner is a brick built culvert for the mill stream. An original railway fence post, and the mill stream continues round there to the mill. I've just subjected the camera to a drop test, which it passed. I don't think I want to test its immersion qualities, so I'll stand back a bit. Big old tree come down there. Been down a while looking at it. And then the embankment carries on. And here on the main road just outside the mill, we see the embankment comes in from the left and goes to the abutment on the right, and the railway carries on. Obviously we're an abutment short of a pair. There's one. And off it heads to Chedworth. Just look at that beautiful brickwork. Then if we come on top of the embankment, just above the stone abutments for the bridge, we find someone's plonked a village hall on the line. On the left you can make out the stone pier, which is on top of the abutment, and the snowdrops are on the embankment on the opposite side of the road. But we go along here, alongside the magnificent village hall.
After which the railway goes from an embankment into a cutting.
And this one's been chiselled out of solid Cotswold stone. Looking back at the village hall, you can see it in its setting, right inside the cutting. Almost looks like a platform on the left. Actually, I think the ledge here acts as a buffer between the rails and the rocks up there. And there's a few rocks scattered around here in the track bed that show you why you might need it. A deep old cutting, which obviously provided the material for the embankment that we were looking at a few moments ago. Tempting. Somebody's 5-star hotel for the night, rather them than me. Just pause here a moment and look at that. Can you imagine? Picking a shovel. The only mechanisation would have been a wheelbarrow. And now we're getting a view of pasture land and a rather fine looking lake. Battered piece of old corrugated. Imagine that had something to do with the railway. And this is as far as we go on the railway then. I don't think we're quite done with the walking yet. Out to a lane, turn right, which brings us back to the railway. And another bridge. Which has seen better days. But does have a very fine abutment. Quite special. Flemish bond, headers and stretchers every fourth course. And it carries on along there and changes to stone, which forms a rather nice driveway for the property there. I will continue to tramp along this rather lovely little lane. Pastures and I think the River Colne. Spring, that's woolly season. Before eventually arriving at this rather fine structure. An accommodation bridge. Who does it accommodate? Well, it could be the landowner, isn't it, really? How marvellous. Your own bridge. Said landowner. A sight for sore eyes. looking closely, the stone has frosted out probably and been replaced by brick. Fine specimen though. Okay, that's us. It's an embankment on our right now, which brings us neatly to here. Want us to miss it. Right, this is described as permanent pasture. Oh, with an ugly one of those plonged right in the middle of it. Then, looking very carefully, first bluebell of the year, for me at least, 22nd of March. A hazelwood coppice. As you would expect, stuffed full of coppice trees. How gorgeous. And what of the railway? Well, if you look very closely in the distance, you can just make out the line of the embankment along there. And then if we look over to the right, we can actually see another bridge. Another accommodation bridge. And that's about all we're going to see of the railway today. From here we leave it as it wends its way, embankments and cuttings, and eventually ends up in Southampton if you get your connections right. Wonderful. Right, well this will be lunch then. Guess what? Cheese and pickle. And we'll stop and look at this rather stunning view. Try to ignore the aeroplanes and contemplate the feat of engineering that we've just seen. Pick, shovel, big muscles and a railway driven from Cheltenham, eventually ending up in Southampton. Although it's true to say that Chedworth is its next destination. We shan't see any more of it now. All we've got to do now is tramp back home, but hopefully that makes quite an interesting video. And onward. Lunch break over.
The earth is our mother, just turning around with a tree. Underground, our Father above us, whose sigh is the wind. Paint us a rainbow without any end. As the river runs freely, the mountain does rise. Let me touch with my fingers and see with my eyes. In the hearts of the children, a pure love still grows. Like a bright star in heaven that lights our way home. Like the flower that shattered the stone. Sparrows find freedom, beholding the sun. In the infinite beauty, we're all joined in one. I reach out before me and look to the sky. Did I hear someone whisper? Did something pass by? as the river runs freely, the mountain does rise. Let me touch with my fingers, see with my eyes, in the hearts of the children a pure love still grows. Like a bright star in heaven that lights our way home, like the flower that shatters the stone. Like a bright star in heaven that lights our way home, like the flower that shatters the stone.
Hill, and there you can just about make out Withington, which is where all this started, with Withington Station. So that was Withington Station then, and the railway. All that toil and effort went into building it, and then it's just forgotten about. Sad. We'll hopefully take a bit of film, show a few people. Perhaps we can all appreciate their efforts. Anyway, I enjoyed it. Always enjoy being out in the Cotswolds, so no surprise there. If you enjoyed it as well, come with me on the next one.